him? When I do, I'm going to scalp him.
Well, it leads you somewhere.
They're at the Reed place. Come on, we're missing it.
See those that are dear to us does not mean that they are no longer with us. Keep your parents alive within you, and their spirits will never die. While you are here, do not stand apart. Follow the Indian way. Be one of us. Tonto will teach you.
The legend started simply, just a boy without a home. Taken in by Indians, but still pretty much alone. He had to struggle with strange customs and his own fears from within. He learned the wisdom of the forest. He learned the ways of the wind.
I recognize my familiar voice as a truth bearer that tells me what to do and what is just and which trail to follow. Trail of Justice.
Go stay with Aunt Martha in Detroit.
Please, Dan, let me stay with you, please. I belong here. This moment, wherever you go, whatever you do, you will always be Kemosabe. Trusted friend.
Thank you.
to hell to find their promised land. The legends tell of one who tried to fight for all the rest, his name unknown, a stranger
practice.
A lawyer. If we didn't have lawyers, we wouldn't have cooks.
You know, I think you're going to sell a pair of these to everybody in Texas.
Yeah, I will. I will. American opportunity, Mr. Reed. Take advantage.
What the hell was that?
Idiots!
Killed.
opportunity.
Told me what you did. I just can't thank you enough. Well, if anything happened to her...
Well, you know, your niece was very courageous, sir. She never compromised an inch.
Perhaps you might join us for supper tonight?
Thank you. I'd like to, but I can't. I have to be at the ranger post before dark.
Oh, are you joining the rangers?
No, sir. My brother.
I see.
Shouldn't have come. You've got an education. You're a lawyer, for Christ's sakes. You got a chance to make something out of your life, but this is not the place.
Dan, what's happened? I mean, what's wrong?
I just don't understand. These are tough times. Chad, I got enough hurt in my life without having to worry about you, too.
When I was 10 years old, you sent me away to learn. And I learned. But the most important thing I learned was that I belong here.
You don't understand. It's still a frontier. It forces you to make sacrifices, to make choices. Your heart can't tell you what to do. Your gut tells you.
Dan. We're the last of the Reeds. You're my brother.
Can't you understand that you don't belong here?
Dan, I've come home. And my gut tells me that I'm gonna stay. Change your mind.
That'll make it safe out here. Safe so a man can raise a family and provide. But I don't know. This territory is endless. That just may be impossible. Bastards come out of nowhere, strike, just disappear. I don't even know where they hold up.
Who's that?
The Cavendish gang.
Cavendish? The other ones that rob a stage.
Cavendish don't rob stages. Cavendish robs ranches. Been grabbing land, driving the owners off. Robbing, killing, burning.
Who is this Cavendish?
Butch Cavendish. Butch for butcher. Major in the Union Army. Dishonorably discharged. Grant court-martialed right after the Battle of Chattanooga. Now he's heading an outlaw army in Texas.
Well, you know you'll get him.
You gonna see him when he comes out here?
Cavendish?
Grant. Grant's coming out here. He's gonna hunt buffalo. Make speeches. Everybody in the whole town's gonna turn out there and wave little flags at him. Me? I like to piss on him.
He's the president of the United States.
He's a liar and a drunk. Piss on the president. Piss on the cabinet. They ain't gonna help us out here, you know. In Texas, robbers are outlaws. In Washington, robbers are elected. Isn't that right? Huh, little brother? John? Well, it is. I don't want to talk about it anymore.
Butch Cavendish lived undisturbed, waging his private war. And men who made mistakes were simply men he could not afford. Some say he was a monster. And others called him mad. Let's just say Butch Cavendish was everything that's bad.
Tribunal that you are in violation of the Articles of War, and your disciplinary conduct resulted in the failure of a military objective. Therefore, it is the pronouncement of this tribunal that you be executed by firing squad forthwith. Mr. Perlmutter.
Sir.
Carry out the orders of the tribunal.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Major Cavendish, sir.
What is it?
Well, sir. Well, it seems to me, sir, that they just did what most men would have done.
I have no room for ordinary men, Mr. Wyatt. We are on a course that will alter the history of this country. Men who do not obey orders for the sake of their own personal gains are a clear and present danger to my plan. Do I make myself understood?
Yes, sir, you do.
Proceed, Mr. Perlmutter.
Yes, sir. Stevens!
Assume the firing position!
My niece, Amy. She's on her way to San Francisco.
How do you do?
Well, John's told me a lot about you.
I read your article in the paper this morning.
Oh, did you like it?
Well, it made me sound like a hero. I enjoyed your editorial about cabbage, Mr. Stryker.
Thank you. More folks laid it on the table like you. We can put an end to him. We'll stop him, Captain. Which reminds me, I've got to get tomorrow's edition out. So if you'll excuse me.
Do you need me to help?
Oh, no, Amy. Stay here and have a good time. Gentlemen,
nice party.
Yes. Isn't it?
Yes, ma'am. All this talking makes me dry. It was very nice to have met you, Miss Amy.
Oh, it was my pleasure, Captain.
Nice party.
You said that already.
Yeah, it did, man.
I have a feeling you're going to be a very important lawyer.
I just want to make sure the West has an honest system of justice.
Oh, you sound just like my uncle.
Here.
Oh, you remembered. A century of dishonor. Thank you.
I'd like to keep it.
I will.
Will you write me and tell me how you like San Francisco?
Yes, of course.
Maybe you could send some articles or stories that you've written.
Of course.
So I guess this is goodbye.
For now. Maybe we should go back.
Amy, I...
I think we should go back.
Get the horses.
Crazy, cranking.
Ay, caramba, le dieron balazo a Hidalgo.
Something like this.
Look at Lopez. Don't hear him griping. He had every swirl and chiquita in the place wanting to marry him.
How's that him riding with us for glory and God in Texas? Hey, Stevenson, why don't you swallow that damn stinking cigar?
Yeah, I could. But he sure keeps my nose warm.
I'm beginning to strongly dislike this Cavendish fella.
Yeah. Wonder if he knows the Rangers are riding right up his ass.
Place for a picnic.
Where the hell are we?
Brian's Gap.
Captain, you want us to ride up ahead, take a look?
Yeah, okay, Collins. But you watch yourself.
Always do, Captain.
Kid, you're gonna love him.
Not if he's anything like you.
Well, he is. Spitting damn image. Jerky?
No, thanks.
I know what you're missing. His mother's gonna let him come out and visit for Christmas.
You really miss it, don't you?
Look,
If anything was ever to happen to me, I want you to check on him for me.
Nothing's gonna happen to you. If it was gonna happen, it would happen a long time ago.
Yeah. Yeah, I suppose. It's just the same, you know. Would you? Okay?
Sure.
You know, our boy needs a father.
What's this for?
It's for you. You can't be shooting outlaws without it. You should know that. There's Collins. Run up. Where is he now? Let's get the hell out of here.
Weren't we, little brother?
No. Yeah.
Pick up the hymn books, boys. It's all over.
Collins.
Yes, sir.
Go down and check the bodies.
Sir, can you send somebody else, sir?
You rode with them.
Well, yes, sir, I did, but... Sir.
One thing about that Cavendish, he knew how to set a trap. And he finished off the Rangers that day in Bryant's Gap. And Collins had to check them all till Butch was satisfied. Dead men lying everywhere. And bloody brothers side by side.
Too coincidental if the only survivor wasn't wounded.
Yes, sir, Major.
Maybe they'll give you a medal.
Yeah.
Dad.
Tonto recognized John Reed by the amulet he wore. But John had once saved Tonto's life, so this evened up the score. Tonto had to hide his friend and keep him out of town, because if Butch had known that one ranger lived, he was sure to hunt him down.
The white man has made many promises to us, yet they keep only one. They promised to take our land from us, and they took it. You see the suffering and the misery they bring to your people, yet you bring one to us to nurse back to health? Tonto, why?
Nobody has reason to fill their hearts with hatred for the white man more than I. He's taken from me my wife and my child. But the man I brought here is my brother, and I will protect his life with my own if I have to. And if I'm wrong, and he proves to be an enemy, then I, Tonto, will decorate my lance with his white man's hair. But until that day comes, let him not be judged by his color, but by his heart, as a man and a friend.
What is it that brings two friends together, or sends the waves to the sand? And what is it that drives a creature of nature to reach out to the world of man? Just such a creature was this great white horse, as wise and as wild as a runaway. And the moment John first laid eyes on him, he swore he'd ride him someday.
Target, like a sleeping buffalo. Try this.
A silver bullet.
It's more accurate. Tribal chiefs first use silver on their arrows. Makes them fly longer and straighter. Silver is pure. It's been a symbol of justice and purity since the year of the sun. Like the moon.
Life's silver. Oh. Easy, boy. That's a boy. Easy, Silver.
Searching for the men that raided my village. I seek right. I will not be herded like soldiers' sheep from pen to pen, or issued my food and clothing by government agents. I am man, and am free to die for what I feel. The day might not be many winter counts away when all men will be brothers. The new Indian nation will come out of this time of change, strong and proud and united.
Well, then let brother ride with brother. If I'm to find Cavendish, I can no longer appear as John Reed. Cavendish and his madness think that All the Rangers were killed in the massacre, and only then will I be free to avenge my brother's death. We will go back to Bryant's Gap and dig one more grave. John Reed will be buried with his brother in the Rangers forever. I swear to you, Dan, no matter how long it takes, no matter where they are, I will find them. But Cavendish and men like him owe you, they will pay in full. There will be justice in the West. To this, my brother, I pledge my life.
Just a memory. The masked man had taken his place. But that doesn't mean his heart wasn't touched when he saw Amy Stryker's face. Amy had stayed to do her uncle's work and to keep his dreams alive. But unless the masked man could find Cavendish, true justice would never survive.
Survivor of Bryant's Gap.
That's right.
What was it like?
It's like hell.
Cavendish?
I don't know who it was. Why are you wearing a mask?
Because I'm in hiding. Like you are.
What are you getting at, mister?
I want you to take me to Cavendish.
How would I know Cavendish?
You led the Rangers to him, and now you're going to lead me to him.
No, see, you got it all wrong. I'm the big hero around here. Isn't that right?
What did they promise you? Was it money? Land? What was worth having your friend slaughtered?
You're crazy. And I don't know what the hell you're talking about.
You know what I'm talking about. Where is he?
I don't know Cavendish.
Why did he set up the Rangers? I know what happened there.
I can't.
You can and you will. Collins, tell me.
The train.
What train?
The train. He wants a train. The mask, man.
Looks like you're gonna hang alone.
Coal tender. Soldier's car. Club car. Presidential car. Are we clear, gentlemen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Whitloff and Richardson.
Yes, sir.
Westlake. Eastman and Neely.
Yes, sir.
Gentlemen, the president.
You're on your way to the happy hunting ground.
Looks like a herd of buffalo.
They're gonna be tough to control.
Don't get in the way, Wyatt. We're taking the Indian. Now just step aside.
Now you listen to me. Two or three, you want to go in there and get him, that's all right. I don't want the rest of you dirtying up the place.
You.
Go get him.
There's only one kind of good Indian.
I don't guess anyone stopped to ask what Tonto was guilty of. That didn't stop him from wanting to see him swinging high above. But Tonto showed no sign of fear. And he held on to a fervent hope that the masked man wouldn't let his bluff brother hang from the end of the rope.
This is Freddie Collins.
Each step of their plan. Meanwhile, old Butch was mighty disturbed by reports of the strange masked man. But he wouldn't let rumors mess up his scheme, so he set out on his final campaign. He and his boys rode to the rendezvous with President Grant's private train.
I best go see what he wants.
You must have done something real bad, Striker.
More coffee, sir?
Thank you.
Well.
Oh, General, come in, gentlemen. Gentlemen, I'd like you to meet our new guest, General Aurelio Rodriguez, is joining us for the hunt.
Oh, Mr. President.
General, I'd like to introduce the legendary Wild Bill Hickok.
Oh, Senor Hickok.
How do you do, sir?
Right there is the famous Buffalo Bill Cody.
Howdy, General.
Senor Buffalo.
And you know, of course, Brigadier George Armstrong Custer.
Brigadier.
General.
Sit down, General. Armstrong, move over there. Let the General sit or send you up to Montana.
You sent for me, Father?
Yes, my child.
your writings. They are very brave, but dangerous.
What do you mean?
In my travels, I have met a man who wears a mask, but is dedicated to law and order. He wants you to know that he will not stop until he has brought Cavendish and his men to justice.
Well, until he finds Cavendish, I shall simply continue with my writings.
No, you must not. You will be hurt. In here, quickly. Please.
You see, Father, I cannot stop my writing. It is my only weapon. It is all I have.
I understand.
Thank you, Father. I am most grateful for your concern. Now, with respect, you must excuse me. I'm on my way to a meeting for President Grant's arrival.
The President?
Yes. He's arriving here on the afternoon train.
Today?
Yes. Although I suspect the children are more eager to see Buffalo Bill than they are to see the President.
My God.
What is the matter, Father?
You should have gone to San Francisco.
What did you say?
I must go.
Wait. The masked man.
Trust him.
Father. Father. Father.
Be there and gone in 3 minutes, not a breath more.
Yes.
Where the hell is Del Rio?
Gentlemen, look what I have to put up with.
Well, I'll leave you on your own. I have to rewrite that speech for whatever the name of that town is.
Gentlemen. Major Bartholomew Cavendish. And you, Mr. President, are my prisoner.
So Cavendish had pulled it off and vanished without firing a shot. The masked man and Tonto had to move fast and ride while his trail was still hot. They didn't know what he intended to do, but the life at stake was President Grant's. Perhaps Butch would hold him. Perhaps Butch would kill him. They just couldn't take that chance.
Thing. Are you here to rescue Grant or to get Cavendish?
I signed your court martial?
I don't remember.
What happened wasn't my fault.
Never is.
I got that at Shiloh. Cavalry Majors. It was his last glorious charge.
Poor bastard.
Thank you.
sir? Do you see chaos, discontent, or do you see respect and order?
I hadn't really noticed.
But you and the United States will notice my country, the Republic of New Texas. The manifest destiny of the United States will be impaired only slightly.
Major Cavendish, you are a diseased son of a bitch.
Your opinion?
Yes.
No, thank you. To Mr. Hamilton Fish, Secretary of State. Dear sir, whereas the government of the United States has failed to provide proper protection for American citizens, and whereas it has failed to provide honest leadership and moral courage, therefore, let it be known that I, Major Bartholomew Cavendish, firmly resolve to hold the President of the United States as my prisoner until I am deeded sovereign right of ownership to the lands of Texas specified in this document. Furthermore, I demand that these lands be granted to me by an irrevocable act of the Congress of the United States no later than 30 days after the date set above, or the life of Ulysses S. Grant shall be forfeit. Sign as witness, please.
Very good.
You think so?
Yes, marvelous. 30 days is too long to give them. I change that. They'll dicker and debate and scratch their indecisive asses, and by the time they sober up, I'll be dead.
You may be right.
Well, be interesting to see.
Wake up, Sheriff. Where's the President?
I don't know what the hell you're talking about.
He's in the next room. I don't know how in the hell you got in here, but you...
President. Excuse me, sir.
Christ, no.
We're here to help.
You don't look like someone that could help me, and neither does he.
Here's a gun. Trust us, sir. We're going to get you out of here. So keep your head down.
Thank you.
Your sins will be paid for in the fires of hell. Take him away.
Yes, sir.
May I know, sir, to whom I am so indebted?
Mr. President, please allow me to remain anonymous. I hope you understand.
Well, I respect your dedication, and I will honor your request. Tonto, I thank you, and I salute you.
Thank me by honoring your treaties with my people.
Yes, we will try. You have my word.
Mr. President?
May God ride with you. Who is that masked man?
They wondered who, but they never knew. The man in the mask.
Hi, Silver! Away!
With his friend Tonto, the daring and resourceful masked rider of the plains led the fight for law and order in the early western United States. Nowhere in the pages of history can one find a greater champion of justice. The Lone Ranger rides again.